couple of months ago, we released a firmware update that included fully reworked Superkeys, a feature that has been in beta for over 4 years. That's just as much as I've been working at Dygma. Now, they simply work. But many of you have requested a development story on how we were able to fix the Superkeys. So, here we are. For those of you who don't know what Superkeys are, here is a quick recap. Superkeys let you assign 5 functions to one key, depending on how you press them. Tap, hold, tap and hold, to tap, and to tap and hold. The keyboard determines which function to output based on timeouts you can configure. For example, by default, if you press a key for more than 200 milliseconds, it will output hold. Or if you press the key twice within 250 milliseconds, it will output two tap. That's a two tap. That's two taps, which is different. In our first attempts back in 2021, Superkeys were extremely slow because they always waited for the next tap timeout, even if only tap and hold were configured. That was our first big step. If nothing were set after hold, the Superkeys would not wait. However, the most challenging part was making modifiers and layer changes feel natural on hold. For example, I have one of my Thumbkeys set to backspace on tap and shift on hold, so when I hold it, I can capitalize my keys very easy. It's important that this works naturally. When typing, we expect the modifiers to trigger the moment we press the following key, like when you press Shift plus A to get capital A. But at the same time, we tend to roll our keys when typing, meaning that we press the following key without fully releasing the previous one. This is a huge problem for Superkeys. If we set them not to trigger when you roll your keys, you would have to wait the whole timeout for the modifier to work, and that can become annoying pretty fast. You have to hold and then press the key, instead of just rolling your keys. If we set Superkeys to trigger the hold the moment you press the following key, you would get plenty of accidental modifiers, and that's even worse. We attempted to add another setting, minimum hold timeout, that only applied in that scenario, but it still didn't feel natural. You had to set it up too high not to get accidental modifiers. So when you wanted the modifier, it would still feel slow. It seems like an impossible problem. The keyboard can't read your mind. Fortunately, we all have a tell. When we don't want the modifier, we roll our fingers faster, which means we release the first key more quickly. The keyboard can measure that release speed and decide. That's the overlap threshold you can see in the settings. The higher the threshold, the less likely you'll get the modifier. Additionally, we maintained the minimum hold timeout. If you press the next key before that time, you will never get a hold. It serves as an additional safeguard to prevent accidental modifiers. There is also another setting, minimum prior interval. It measures the time elapsed between the previous key press and the key that has the modifier. If it's lower than the time set, the hold function won't trigger. This is useful because we usually pause for a split second before intentionally pressing a modifier, so the time elapsed is higher than when we type normally. If you'd like to explore this logic in more detail, I've included a link to a flowchart in the description. To make things more complicated, these settings only apply when a layer change or a modifier is on hold, so we had to make the firmware filter the Superkeys with that configuration. And that's just the main thing we fixed. Let me list the rest. Now you can add multiple modifiers on hold. Before, they didn't hold. We fixed a bug that prevented you from using a Superkey in combination with another Superkey. We also addressed an issue where modifiers wouldn't work on tap and hold onwards. Caps Lock now works when assigned to a Superkey. We fixed a bug where modifiers on a Superkey would affect the previous key. We addressed an issue where layer changes on Superkeys would always return to layer 1. Now you can assign LED toggle to hold on a Superkey. We fixed a bug where shifting to a layer using a Superkey would only allow Superkeys on those layers to work on tap and hold. Now, when you hold a Superkey, it will repeat the function on hold while holding it. we also fixed a bug where Superkeys didn't work with one-shot modifiers. That's it, although maybe I forgot to mention some things that we also fixed. Nonetheless, the Superkeys are still not perfect. Some minor bugs have surfaced with the new release. For example, if you tap a Superkey multiple times, you get two taps instead of multiple taps. And fast Superkeys don't interrupt the one-shot layer timeout. We'll tackle them in the next update. Once again, thank you so much to all of you who helped polish the Superkeys through your beta testing and detailed bug reports. If you want to learn how to use and configure Superkeys, or use them as homebrew modifiers, check out these videos. Until the next one!